Hey guys, welcome to today's video. Well, today in this video we are going to fix the PCV membrane of the car, because the original one I have got ripped. So I was talking about boost leaks and all of you told me, hey, go check this out. And I checked it out and I didn't even have to open it to see that it was leaking, because there was oil around the intake tube. So today we are going to replace it, and it's a fairly easy job. So the membrane is actually sitting under here, and normally for most ones here that don't have a strut brace, it's actually fairly easy, because you just have to remove that cover. But now for me, the strut brace is in its way, so I actually have more work to do. So I will remove the strut brace by, you know, just removing the 6 bolts over here, and then I can remove the cover, and then we can go get the membrane replaced. But yeah, first we'll have to remove the strut brace. But you know, I'm not really going to show that. It's just removing these 6 bolts and that's it, because you know, most of you guys won't have a strut brace and you won't have to do this, so it's extra work for me. Hooray. Okay, so we got the strut brace removed, and now you just easily remove this. So you literally like pull it off. It's literally as easy as that, almost, yeah. And you just toss it aside. And yeah, it's a little bit dirty on under here, because I actually spilled some oil. But as you can see here, this is absolutely filthy, and that's because the rubber, this one that sits under there, is leaking. Hooray. So yeah, we are going to toss this aside for a second. You can probably just unplug this, I guess. I'm not sure. I'm going to leave it in. But yeah. So you take this off with a lot of force, because it's a really bitch to unget. And I don't know what's happening, but am I finding some coolant into my oil? I hope not. It can also be just be, you know, moist from not driving that much the last time, but maybe we'll have to look at that 140i replacement. That's not good. Shit. But yeah, it is what it is, I guess. I mean, my mechanic told me that my head gasket was still fine, so I guess that's just moist. But yeah, as you can see, the membrane here was starting to rip, so the new one will go in. I did manage to crack this though, so I'm not 100% sure how well it will secure. It's very possible that I'll need to get a new one. Yeah, fortunately. Yeah, it is what it is. This is very, it was stuck on very, very hard, and yeah. Yeah, not that good. But yeah, it is what it is, like I said. Okay, so this is basically on like that, and you have to pry it off. And you have to be careful if you only have one of these, because I luckily have two of them. I took precaution because I broke this one. And I cracked it. It's very brittle plastic. Even when it was hot, it still cracked. So be, you know, it's handy if you have a second one, if you're not that handy like me. So now we just basically, like I said, you know, it caps on like this, and then you just push it back and hope to hear a clicking noise that it stays on, and then we should be fine. But it seems not to be 100% secure, so I'm going to do that off camera. Okay, so I fiddled a little bit around with it, and I just actually kind of forgot to film, but that was actually it. So you just push that back in, and then you can reassemble everything. So basically, normal people without a strut brace just have to put the cover back on, and that's it. I had to reinstall the strut brace, but yeah, I actually already took some draggy runs, and from the 100 to 200 time, we are hitting about the same number. So I don't think that the PC, the little rubber thingy was really that broken on mine, because as you can see here, like there is a rip over here, so it's ripped. where was it? Yeah, here. I think, if I was correctly, it's not that easy to see with one hand. Yeah, here you can see. See here, it was ripped. So, so there was a little vac, you know, leak. The only thing is the new cover that I have. I just can't to seem to put it on 100% tight. As the last one, I retried it like 100 times, and you know, it was hard to take off. So it's really, you know, stuffed in there really good, and I pushed it on all sides, and it was great. We don't have boost leaks, so I guess it's fine. But yeah, so also the coolant leak, like I said, we got that sorted out. The coolant is finally staying in place again. We have the membrane leak, it's basically fixed. I don't think it was really that broken, but you know, precautions. Anyway, it wasn't that expensive. So we got the coolant leak fixed, we got the PCV membrane fixed. So basically the car now is good again and ready to tune engine wise. There's still some other stuff that we have to do with the rattling of the exhaust and stuff like that, but that will be, you know, fixed later on. But you know, engine wise, everything is is back at perfect shape. So the next things that we will do is the blow off valve, because I'm still thinking I'm losing I'm still thinking I'm losing boost through the DV Plus and then the Android screen. But that will be for pretty soon though. So yeah. Anyway guys, that was it for today's video. Now I'm gonna have a little bath and I'm going to sleep, because it's 1 a.m. actually already. So and we have to work again tomorrow, fortunately. Tough life. Anyway guys, see you next time. Bye.